A fascinating new study conducted by Stanford University and published in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition is the first clinical trial of Beyond Meat's plant-based products. According to the study authors, until now, there's been limited evidence of the health effects of plant-based alternative meats, despite their popularity. So they set out to compare the effects of consuming plant-based alternative meat, as opposed to animal meat, on health factors. This randomized crossover trial had 36 participants follow a diet of either meat or plant-based alternatives for a total of 16 weeks. 8 weeks one way, and then they swapped for the next eight. Half of the participants ate the plant alternative diet, while the other half ate the meat-based diet, consisting of primarily red meat, although some participants ate some chicken as well. Then they switched. Both groups had two servings of meat or plant-based alternatives per day, logging their meals, receiving dietary counselling, lab assessments, microbiome assessments, and anthropometric measurements. Participants had to keep all other foods and beverages as similar as possible between the two phases. And here's what the researchers found. They found that when the participants swapped their protein from animal to plant-based meat, their levels of LDL cholesterol dropped by an average of 10 milligrams per deciliter, which is said to be statistically significant and clinically significant too. Participants also lost 2 pounds on average during the plant-based portion of the study. The modest weight loss observed when participants substituted the plant-based meats in places of the red meats is an unexpected finding, since this was not a weight loss study, said Anthony Cromarco, the lead author of the study. Plant-based meats also reduced TMAO levels among participants, trimethylamine-N-oxide. This appears to be very significant, as this recent study found that people with elevated TMAO had a 60% higher risk for adverse cardiovascular events, such as heart attack. Other studies have shown that high levels of TMAO coexist with inflammation, the buildup of plaque, and the hardening of arteries. In the Beyond Meat study, participants eating red meat for the first 8 week phase had an increase in TMAO, whilst those who ate the plant-based meat in the first 8 weeks did not. When the group switched diets and the group that had been eating meat twice a day switched to a plant-based diet, they showed a decrease in TMAO levels. However, what was most interesting was that when the group that had been eating plant-based switched to meat, they did not see an increase in TMAO, suggesting that there might be some lingering protection. Christopher Gardner, professor of medicine at the Stanford Prevention Research Center, said, "It was pretty shocking. We had hypothesized that it wouldn't matter what order the diets were in. It turns out that there are bacterial species responsible for the initial step of creating TMAO in the gut. These species are thought to flourish in people whose diets are red meat heavy, but perhaps not in those who avoid meat." So for the participants who had the plant-based diet first, during which they ate no meat, we basically made them vegetarians, and in doing so may have inadvertently blunted their ability to make TMAO. This is extremely promising. Beyond Meat burgers do contain relatively high levels of saturated fat, and were thought to contain more added sodium than a regular meat burger, which raised the question whether meat substitutes are in fact any better for us than meat. Now we know a diet centered around whole plant foods is the healthiest for humans. However, in the study, researchers found similar sodium intake and blood pressure levels between the animal-based and plant-based phases of the study, which appears to debunk the myth that consuming plant-based meats results in higher sodium intake. It's important to note that this study was funded by Beyond Meat. But that said, the study concluded, among generally healthy adults, contrasting plant with animal intake, while keeping all other dietary components similar, the plant products improved several cardiovascular disease risk factors, including TMAO. There were no adverse effects on risk factors from the plant products. This was a quite remarkable study, but I think we still need to be very cautious over the levels of sodium in these plant-based alternative meat products. We looked in more detail at the detrimental effects of a high salt intake in this previous video. Be sure to check it out. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below, and subscribe for more upcoming videos.